regarding floods and droughts. Chairman, last Thursday and day before yesterday, both day, I raised the same issue before the House. And I am sincerely thanking to Honorable MOS visited Kerala, and he has, I think, first-hand information about the entire calamities. First of all, Chairman Saab, I would like to pay homage to the people of 120 people who has lost their life through this calamity. Earlier, he told that before 4 months, we lost around 100 people, and some of them are still missing. If, whether they are coming or not, there is no surety. That means in within 4 months, we are losing more than 250 people through these calamities. Chairman, I would like to specifically tell two people from the Matrubhumi News Channel, Saji and Bibin. Those who went to report the calamities also lost their lives. These two guys, actually they gone for an adventurous reporting the natural calamities, and while going to the area, they lost their valuable life. Therefore, I want to place in record in that about the adventurous journalism of that bulls. One journalist and one driver. They are already lost. Government should take care of their families also, along with others. Chairman Saab, here already Karunakaranji mentioned about the calamities. It is in my constituency, Alappuzha. I am representing that parliamentary constituency. My colleague Kudikunna Suresh is representing Kuttanadu constituencies. Day before yesterday and yesterday, we visited the maximum camps and flooded areas. Due to actually day before yesterday night, I am hospitalized with this food poisoning. But I am voluntarily discharged from the hospital. I came to here to participate in the discussion before, because my people in my constituency, we can't imagine their sorrows. We can't imagine their agonies. When I visited to the Kuttanad area, the people, the temporary shelters, you can see the temporary shelters, not even a shed. They are residing in a bund without any protection. How can they live there? I can't describe it, because that is a pathetic condition of that situation. Entire paddy field has been damaged. There is no livelihood income for fishermen. They are not even in a position to go for fishing. They are all in a very difficult situation. Therefore, that is why we are asking for it should be discussed in the parliament. Something has to be given to them. Every time this type of floods come, drought come, I'm not blaming any single government. The government should promise something, but nothing is going to happening. Only meager amount. Here Karunakaranji told about the OCKHI. In my constituency, four people went for fishing and they lost their these things. After all, finally, for God's sake, they come back by losing their entire boats and entire machinery for fishing. Not yesterday also I gave about nothing has been given to them. OCKHI, here they told so many promises has been to the OCKHI victims, but so far there is no fulfillment. That is why this time also we are asking the parliament should consider this seriously, and the government should consider this seriously. The people's life is such. Kuttanad is the rice bowl of Kerala. Kuttanad is the rice bowl. This is a low level land. Whenever a flood is coming, those people will be in the flood only. But this time, it is unprecedented. That type of things are happening there. Therefore, I am urging upon the government to intervene in a faster way. What happened? Honorable MOS came there. I am appreciating that. But you have to send the official team now. What is happening every time? When this official team is going, there will be no flood at that time. Then they will report that nothing is there. But that is why I am telling you, constitute the officers team immediately and send it to Kerala for at least have an estimate. Hectares of paddy fields and cash crop were damaged due to the devastating flood and rain. The economic loss of this damage is yet to be estimated. There is a serious lack of proper medical facilities. The temporarily arranged camps are unable to provide proper care and shelter and drinking water for the suffering people. I already told, I had visited some of the camps in my constituency and Kuttanadu. the condition of the people is very pathetic there. They are living in a temporarily arranged high-mounted places, not a shelter. High-mounted places in the flooded areas. They don't have a safe drinking water. They are spending their day and night in the camps arranged in the schools. The schools are also underwater. The students studying in the school are staying as a refugee in the same school. That is what is happening everywhere there. The living condition of the people are beyond imagination. The flood and heavy rain have brought venomous snakes to the camps. That is very dangerous. Venomous snakes now, they are out. They are all coming into the camps. The children and senior citizens are suffering the worst. The people above 70 years are in a very, very difficult situation. The houses are underwater. As you know, after a period of time, the flooded water will create serious safety issues to the houses. All the houses are broken. Now also, you can see that all the houses are broken. Their walls are broken. The farmers are not only suffering the mental agony for financial losses also. They have lost their crops. They are already suffering with heavy burden of debt and crop loss. Government should consider it. In addition to this, poor fishermen are the worst affected. They are not recovered from the loss done by OCKHI cyclone so far. The sea erosion and seawater has entered into the water. Their inhabitants have lost. They are the people belonging to the socially and economically marginalized section. You know about the fishermen's community's state of affairs. The fishermen also need a special care and protection. Then CRS norm, several times we asked the government to change the CRS norm. They are not in a position to alter their houses. They are not in a, honorable minister is there, I know he is taking interest on that, but it has to be decided early. As you know, any kind of natural calamity will have a serious impact on state like Kerala. Kerala is the third most densely populated in the country. Third large population is there. So it has a high degree of vulnerability. 14.5% of the state is flood prone. 14.4% of the same is landslide prone. 55.5% of the coastline prone to coastal hazards. This is the geographical condition of our state, Honorable Chairman. This year, monsoon started off with immense calamities. The Indian Meteorological Department declared the start of monsoon over Kerala 29 May. Quantitatively, the monsoon seasonal rainfall is likely to be 97% of the long period. The National Remote Sensing Center, ISRO, has informed that 50,007 hectare land area of Kerala has been affected by flood. There is a district wise chart. Alappuzha flooded affected area is 21,799. Ernakulam 2,056. Kottayam 12,301. Pathanamthitta 2,322. Malappuram 1,338. Kollam 1,503. Trichur 13688. Total 55,007 hectares has been affected badly. Land. 14 lives were lost in landslide before 1 month. Over 96 villages out of 1,033 villages have been affected by either floods, landslides, extremely heavy rainfall or strong winds. This Kerala is facing a historic calamity due to monsoon rainfall of 2018. I already told 21,197 crops has been lost, hectare crops has been lost. Houses damaged, 11,304 houses has been damaged totally. Therefore, around 88,000 people are in the camps. The statistics are unable to express the suffering and sad plight of the common people living in the camp. I already told, I visited along with the political Suresh MB in the flood affected area in his constituency also, in my constituency also. The people are lacking basic amenities in the camp. Due to the waterlogging situation, they are even facing problem to cremate the dead bodies also. That is also a very, very important point. The flooding has raised the groundwater level of the low-lying parts of Alappuzha and Kottayam, making most of the toilet in the area non-usable. That is one dangerous. When flood will be over, this epidemic will come fast, because the situation is like that. The central government's approach However, even after this very severe flood and human, the central government is unwilling to beyond the lead of NDRF domes. You given 80 crores. That is under NDRF domes. Every state has the right to have NDRF domes. You are given 80 crore rupees. I am not criticizing that. But it should be beyond the NDRF norms. Then only Kerala will be benefited. Otherwise, it will not be benefited Kerala. As per Section 47 of the Disaster Management 2005 Act, it is the obligation of the central government to create a national disaster mitigation fund. While Kerala notified mitigation fund and utilizing it effectively, the central government is yet to notify NDA, MF and provide funds to government of Kerala for undertaking long-term disaster mitigation work. I would also like to point out that after the OCKHI cyclone happened in Kerala, government has requested for, your Karnakaran ji told, 7,300 something. What you have given, we do not know, nothing. I already told about the situation. Fisherman is not getting anything. That has to be taken care. The funds available in the state disaster response fund is 203 crores. This is very insufficient to meet the demands of current crisis. I would also point out the details of fund demanded by the state government and the total amount of fund released by the central government so far. State government, only central government has given state disaster response, SDRF, from SDRF 203 crores. NDRF 80 crores.
State spent more than that.
Therefore, there should be some immediate relief from your central part. There should be an immediate, I think, by replying, the Honorable Minister will give some clarification on that area. In Alappuzha and Kottayam district, the severe flood had made the life of the people in Kuttanad region. The Kuttanad region, situating below the sea line, is highly vulnerable to floods. However, the well-known reports of M.S. Swaminathan, which led to the creation of Kuttanad package, received only partial assistance. Government has stopped that special package. Therefore, it should be revamped. My suggestion is that this is in a standstill now due to lack of assistance from the central government. For the disaster management and rescue missions, the help of army, Karnakaranji, I am totally supporting the view presented by Karnakaranji. Army should be equipped, Navy to be equipped, Coast Guard should be equipped, because we want to save the valuable life of the common people. Therefore, it should be, these forces should be equipped in a larger level. I had pointed out that problem and failure of weather forecasting also. In the state, in the contest of OCKHI in this August, I raised the same issue. The accuracy of the district-wise rainfall prediction of India Meteorological Department is nowhere near to reality. The IMD operates with just 56 rain gauges. It hardly has about 7 temperature measurement stations and 1 solar radiation measurement stations. No real-time rainfall data is made available to the disaster management authorities. The cyclone warning dissemination system of IMD in the state is not operational even after cyclone OCKHI tragedy. Central Water Commission has not yet created even one flood warning center in the state, even though the state is prone to flood and rainy related calamities. I would like to demand the Prime Minister and Honorable Home Minister to declare the flooding situation of Kerala of 2018 is a calamity of severe nature. I'm totally supporting that point. And consider the memorandum submitted by the government of Kerala for an amount of ₹831.1 crore for immediate relief on 21-5-2018. Honorable Minister of State or Home Affairs, favorably, you have to look after that. Considering the fact that it is a second consecutive disaster adjoining seasons in November and monsoon calamity starting May, the Government of India should permit Kerala to exercise the provision of second consecutive disaster and to give relief assistance given to the affected community can be raised at least marginally within the NDRF norms. There is a need to immediately consider ₹7,340 crore OCKHI package requested by Government of Kerala and provide assistance under the major heads of assistance requested them. I would also demand to provide continued assistance to complete the implementation of the Samidhanam package. There should be a special package because I already told Kuttanad is the rice bowl of Kerala. Though if Kuttanad is losing, then we are in a very difficult situation. Entire Kerala is in a very difficult situation to for e-food. The government must ensure that the defense service corps in Kannur and the army, I already told, that should be equipped. I would also request that Indian Air Force to be equipped in a larger level. Heavy helicopter in Thiruvananthapuram for emergency use in the state shall be established. Regarding the strengthening of IMD and make the organization provide real-time rainfall data and accurate predictions to the state, IMD should ideally have at least 300 rain gauges in the states at the rate of one rain gauge plus about 10 square kilometers. I am concluding. IMD should post one meteorologist at least in a district level. Then only it can be fruitful. I would also request the government to immediately set up at least one automated weather station for weather monitoring and assistance of accurate localized weather predictions. There is an urgency of immediately order to set up 5 digital cyclone warning discernment systems in Kerala. They being in Thiruvananthapuram, Alappuzha, Ernakulam, Kozhikode and Kasaragod. And immediately under Central Water Commission to set up flood warning centers in Karamankili, Manimala, Meenachil, Pamba and Bharatapura and Periyar rivers of the state. In addition to this, flooded regions are highly vulnerable to infection and other seasonal epidemics. The spread of Nipah virus, Karnakaranji told here, Nipah virus, that also created very, very alarming situation for the Kerala. Therefore, there is a need of upgradation of virology institute. In my constituency, there is a virology institute, National Institute of Virology, Alappuzha. It should be equipped in a larger way, because when Nipah was got, we see that there is no much sufficient laboratory to establish the disease. Therefore, that is a need of strengthening the virological institute. I would request the Honorable Health Minister to take measures to improve the facilities at the Virology Institute in Alappuzha Medical College. In this context, I would request the Prime Minister to declare the flood and casualty caused by rain as a natural calamity and take measures to declare an inclusive financial package beyond the norms. We need an inclusive financial package beyond the norms in this time of grief and agony. I would also request to adopt a comprehensive mechanism to estimate the financial loss to ensure adequate compensation as early as possible. But our people are in a very, very critical condition. They are in a very vulnerable condition. Therefore, I am, through this of August House, I am requesting the Honorable Minister and the government to come forward with some concrete assistance proposal. Otherwise, if it is like a OKHI, then there is no meaningness for discussing this in the house. Therefore, with great pain, with folded hands, Speaker, with folded hands, with great pain, I am requesting the minister and the government to do immediately some relief to Kerala, to take immediate steps for addressing this type of calamities in future. Thank you.